Do you want more peace in your life? That's a dumb question. Of course you do. We don't have a ton in common, but I think every human being wants more joy and more peace, because peace is one of those things that we just need to get through the day and be okay. I think of peace as the ability to push back on bad news. It's when fear just wants to consume you and you keep that fear on a leash. Peace is the ability to read a bad headline or have someone criticize you, and you take a deep breath and you say things like, "But God. But God's got this. But God accepts me. But God knows the truth." Peace isn't about having a perfect life. It's about knowing a perfect God who runs all of our lives. And who wouldn't want more of that? But you've probably figured out what I have, right? Peace is no joke. I mean, I said bad news before, but when the bad news is specific and when it's personal, it's so easy for peace to completely disappear. Right? I think about all the financial things that you might be going through. The credit card debts, paying for tuition, the medical bills, the divorce, the lawyer's fees, the job cutback, the hours, the business, the debt you've taken on, the student loans. I thought I was in a pretty good financial spot, and then the dentist said, "Your daughter needs braces." And then I found out how much braces cost, right? Like in an instant, I start thinking about how I'm going to make this work and pay these bills, and do we have enough money, and what do we have to cut back on? And that's just the financial. There's the physical, which is probably way worse than a financial. There's the mental health struggles, the depression, the anxiety. There's the bad back. There's the getting older. There's the knees that need to be replaced and the hips and the things you can't play and the muscles that tear and the recovery time. And that's just the physical. There's the relational. Right? I think it could be broke and physically broken if all my relationships were strong. But when there's tension in your home, when things are kind of difficult with your dad, when you don't really want to be with your mom, your kids, your spouse, or you're not sure if this relationship is going to make it. And I could keep going, right? I don't want to depress you, but I think you get the point. Something happens every day that threatens our peace. And that's why we pray, "God, change this. God, give me the money. God, please don't let the other kid need braces too." Like, we just want him to fix all of these things so we have a perfect life, because once we have a perfect life, once the trouble is gone, then we can get this thing we want called peace. But do you know who wouldn't agree with that? Jesus. The night before he died, Jesus was in an upper room with his friends. He celebrated the Lord's Supper, he washed their feet, and he spoke these amazing words. He said in John chapter 16, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." I love that. Jesus wasn't saying to Peter and James and John, "It's going to be easy. You'll be fine. Don't worry, no troubles. I'm about to die for your sins." No, he's honest enough to say, "In this world you will have trouble, but don't worry. Take heart, I'm speaking to you so that in me you may have peace." So let me teach you a really simple technique that's really difficult to do, but it might help you with your peace. The first thing that happens when you feel afraid, think about Jesus. Right? When the doctor says it's cancer, before we think about the chemo plans and life expectancy, and before we Google it, before we talk to other people, like, let your fear be a trigger to think of Jesus. Because Jesus said, "In me, you may have peace." Think about who he is. Think about where he is. Think about what he's done. Think about what he's promised. Right? When the bill comes in the mail, when you're behind, when the relationship is like on the fence and you don't know if it's going to make it, like, there will be plenty of time to think about all the what ifs. Let the first portion of your time think about this, Jesus. This rock solid, unchanging, this beautiful, same yesterday and today and tomorrow, Jesus. That's the secret to peace. It's not a perfect life. Peace is found in a person, and his name is Jesus. That's what my friend Phil said. I have this friend named Phil. He used to be the principal of the Christian school that my kids attend. And in his 40s, he was diagnosed with a shocking diagnosis. He had cancer. And all cancer is bad, but Phil's cancer was bad. But it was the craziest thing to watch my friend Phil battle cancer, because he was not afraid. I put it this way. My friend Phil was a peace beast. Like, I was waiting for him to lose it. I was waiting for the tough exterior to crack. At times, I thought he was in denial about the seriousness of his diagnosis, but he wasn't. He was good. He didn't know if he'd get better or not. He didn't know if he was going to live or die. He didn't know if his ministry was over, if his life was over, if he would leave wife and kids behind. But he just had this peace. And so I asked him, like, Phil, how did you do that? I would have been freaking out. I would have worried about how my kids would have handled the death of their father at such a young age. How did you do that? And Phil actually sent me back an answer. I brought it with me today because I wanted to read it word for word. He said, "My faith gives me peace." A passage I often go to is John chapter 16, where Jesus said, "I've told you these things so that in me you may have peace." My biggest problem was sin, but God solved it. He sent his son Jesus to be my one sacrifice. I have heaven because of Jesus. I understand that I will face earthly struggles, but the Bible tells me God is our God forever and ever. God will be our guide even to the end. In short, by faith, I know that God is here. I hope that helps. Phil. Well, that does help, Phil. God is here. Peace isn't a perfect life. It's found in a person. His name is Jesus. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for being here. And thank you for being you. Whatever we're worried about today, whatever kept us up last night, whatever sparks and triggers our anxiety, it is not bigger than you. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are our Savior. You sit at the right hand of God and you are running the show. So before we worry and wonder and what if ourselves to death, help us to think of you. Let your Holy Spirit give us that ability and that power to have faith, to be like Phil, and to find peace. I pray this in your name. Amen. Did you enjoy this video? Well, we would love to share with you so much more. Just click here.